We are team 217 and we will be presenting credit analysis report on Adani Ports and Sells. Adani Ports is India's largest private multi-port operator with 10 ports, out of which 9 are operational. And the company has handled approximately 21% of the country's cargo volume in financial year 19, up from about 10% which was in financial year 10. With a well-balanced operational ports across the eastern and the western parts of the country, the company is accessible for imports from US, UK, Chinese and Japanese market. And Mundra being the company's largest port, it accounts for around 66% of the consolidated volume as of March 2019. Therefore, using the top-to-bottom approach, we would analyze the industry first and then analyze the company's performance. Now, looking at the industry overview, there has been an increase in the container handling segment, and according to the reports of Quintiles and IMS Health Inc., global population and demand is expected to increase. And with initiatives like Make in India, it will result in an increased container volume by 1.5 times of what it is now. Furthermore, the container volume in India is expected to grow at a rate of 65% by the financial year 25. As per the reports of Ministry of Commerce and Industry, the impact of import figures for financial year 2019 would be around $26,000, whereas import figures is said to be stood at approximately $26,000 in financial year 2019, and is expected to be from against the $23,000 in financial year 2019 with an increase of 14%. The coal demand is been rising in the country, and Adani Ports benefits from having 26% of total cargo in coal. Looking at the demand side, the power demand is assumed to be growing at a rate of 6% throughout the financial year 25, and the global coal requirement is estimated to be around 1200 billion units. We estimate thermal coal requirement for utilities to be increasing and to reach around 670 metric tons by financial year 25. While on the supply side, the private miners will ramp up the mines and the capacity would be increasing to around 65 metric tons. Looking at the strong demand and supply drivers, the company is going to be benefited as a coal handling port, and is considered to be having the highest share in cargo imports and export. Talking about the cargo growth and diversification, India's port handling is expected to grow at a CAGR rate of 5.5% in financial year 25.
Moving on to the company's business model, Adani Ports is the largest developer of ports and related infrastructure and a pan-India integrated logistics service provider. A CAGR rate of approximately 11% between financial year 17 to financial year 19, Adani Ports has been recognized as top 5 fastest growing port players in the world. To give an overview about the operations of the company is engaged in 3 major operations: port handling, logistics and SEZ. As previously highlighted, out of the 10 ports, Mundra Port is the country's largest commercial. Mundra Port is the company's largest commercial port in terms of volume, with a handling capacity of 252 million tons of cargo. The company has 6 ports on the western coast and four ports on the eastern part of it. Talking about the Mundra ports, in terms of volume, with the handling it has a handling capacity of 252 million tons of cargo. The company has 6 ports on the western coast and four ports on the eastern coast of the country. With regards to return on capital employed, due to higher capacity utilization in the years, the return on capital employed set to increase from 13.5% to 16% in financial year 25. In case of logistics and special economic zones, the company owns more than 8,000 hectares of land. Well integrated with ports, warehouses and coal, Mundra Port is the the company's largest commercial ports in terms of volume, with a handling capacity of 252 million tons of cargo. The company has 6 ports on the western coast and four ports on the eastern part of it. Talking about the Mundra ports, in terms of volume, with the handling it has a handling capacity of 252 million tons of cargo. The company has 6 ports on the western coast and four ports on the eastern coast of the country. With regards to return on capital employed, due to higher capacity utilization in the years, the return on capital employed set to increase from 13.5% to 16% in financial year 25. In case of logistics and special economic zones, the company owns more than 8,000 hectares of land, well integrated with ports, warehouses and cold storages and largest private rail network for enhanced logistics. Talking about the business model, Adani Ports basically generates revenue from three operations, mainly handling of ports and cargo, logistics and SEZ. Apart from its core operations, Adani also provides dredging, reclamation services, cargo handling, storage and logistics. Moving forward to corporate governance, the MD and CEO of Adani Ports is Mr. Gautam Adani, and there are 5 independent directors. The list of independent directors is Ms. Nirupama Rao.
Talking about their revenue breakup, the port contributes to around 81% of the total revenue, followed by 5% by logistics, 7% by SEZ, and the remaining 7% comes from the non-operating sources of the company. And it expects the growth in revenue for the next year to be around 12-14%. As per the latest news, Adani is planning to acquire 3 more airports, summing up to its portfolio of 6 airports, which we believe will improve its efficiency in terms of logistics. In terms of operating revenues, the revenues have increased by 20% in financial year 19, and this is mainly due to the income from port operations, which grew by approximately 22%. The operating expenses have remained streamlined because of the operational efficiency that is being managed by the company. And in fact, that has reflected in the growth of 40% in the EBITDA margins and increase in 65% of the EBITDA. Moving forward to the key debt ratios, the interest coverage ratio is 4 times and debt to be paid off in 12 months is around 1184 crores and the liquidity position of the company stands at 2474 crores, which suggests that the company is heavily positioned to pay off its debt in its long-term obligations. Talking about the total debt to EBITDA, which stands at 3.6 in financial year 19 and 4.1 in financial year 2018, the decrease has primarily because of the increase in accounts receivable and in EBITDA partially offset. Talking about the debt to EBITDA ratio, that stands at 3.6 in financial year 19 versus 4.1 in financial year 18, the decrease is primarily on account of increase in EBITDA partially offsetting the increase in debt ratio.
Moving forward to the credit rating of Adani Ports, Moody's, Fitch and S&P Global have all given Adani Ports an investment grade rating with a stable outlook. However, we believe in the short-term headwinds caused due to corona outbreak, US sanctions on Iran, geopolitical tensions such as import ban on palm oil from Indonesia will all have an effect on the business revenues. So, according to the reports from the Department of Commerce, India imports approximately 9% of the total imports from China. We believe that corona pandemic will last for up to 9 to 12 months, which will disrupt the global trend. This may affect the major operations of Adani Ports, which we believe will downgrade the outlook from stable to a negative outlook. The GDP forecast for India has been downgraded from 5.6% to 4.6% from Fitch. That's all from my side. Thank you.
मेरा वापस लेना है क्योंकि कट करने कैसे करना है?